Because some of these people just emphasize democracy, but democracy without a vision, it would become sterile democracy. It must be democracy to achieve something. So because of this line, which we started as a student movement, we were able to build, first of all, a national political party. Because you remember, I told you that in 1962, no party could win 50% of the votes in Uganda, because they were all sectarian. But because we came with the line of saying interests, not identity, people now, they all have similar interests. We realized, number one, love Uganda. Number two, love Africa. But you will not love Africa if you do not wake up, if you are asleep. Because when you are asleep, you are satisfied with what you have. You don't know. You don't know what you are lacking. So that's why we said no. Our student movements said, point number three must be socio-economic transformation. The society must change. Must change. Because see, this is the big difference between Europe and Africa. Since 1400, Europe has been changing. Instead of using manual labor, using muscles and sometimes animal power, the Europeans from around 14 something started realizing the importance of machine power, until they discovered the water pump, the engine for pumping water. Then they went to the steam engine, electricity, automation. Now there is the artificial intelligence, machines which can do the work of man, is very big danger to Africa. We must go from manual labor to intellectual labor, to the labor of the brain, not just the labor of the muscle. And all the elements of socio-economic transformation. We must build a middle class.